Okay, I'm gonna do a little video here. We're gonna talk about the measurements of the Geico model 1925. I had a question a couple days ago about this. I think if you look this thing up on YouTube, I pretty much have the only videos on it, so I get quite a few comments, and those videos are actually some of my highest viewed, or like every month or whatever, for some strange reason. But these guns were super common or something. They were sold all over. I'm not quite sure Geico actually built these. I think they were made by one of the other German gun companies, so they might be similar to other models. I'm not quite sure. There's like a model 1919 and some other ones. I don't know if the Strachters are the same. And like the Germans used this type of extractor in a lot of their guns. Even my Ducato 22 that I got, that's made quite a lot later, has this type of extractor, but it's made out of a stamping instead of a milled piece of steel like this one. And it's quite a common question on a lot of forums. Anyway, so I drew some sort of diagrams here and put most of the measurements that I could think of that would be useful or would help to make, I guess, to fabricate a new one. Like this top diagram is basically the extractor sitting on its side like this. This middle one is the extractor sitting that, looking from above. This one here is it looking at it from this direction. Some of these measurements are, they're probably not exact. Like if you measure, like you say, like the thickness of this here, you measure it here, measure it there. There's tiny variations. And same with like here, you measure it there, measure it here. It's a little bit, tiny bit different. But when you put it in the gun, it kind of wobbles a little bit, and you could hand fit it. It's, I think the only part that really has to be sort of exacting is, or a bit more exacting, is where it goes in, and this, it creates the bottom part of the back of the chamber here and where the shell sits and stuff. That's probably the bit more picky part of it, and it's chamfered on all the front surfaces other than where the casing is. It's probably just so it makes it get into that recess a little easier. And there's some areas where I can't really, like there's this rounded area here, couldn't really measure that for you. The little angle on the little hook on the back that the bolt grabs a hold of, I'll just have to kind of guesstimate that in the how high this little section is. It looks similar height to this part here, but it's a tiny bit shorter, it looks like, anyway. But it's like the groove that it goes into, it's it really matters, because this is square and this probably could be square. I don't think it would matter really that much. So anyway, so I guess the best way is just to take a picture of this, and I think most of the measurements are fairly self-explanatory. Like I measured like how long it is the whole way, how high this little hook is, how tall it is here, how wide it is on here, how wide that cut is for the where the shell is to a point. But you'll have to figure out that you're for yourself. I don't know if they like reamed the chamber when and had this, or cut it a little bit and then reamed the chamber and this together to get that basically the same. But anyway, you'll have to figure that out yourself. So the height of this, the width of that, the thickness of this, how high it is, like this part here, how thick it is, how thick or wide this part is. Get a measurement from this front part of this hook to here. But I think most measurements are written out fairly obvious what they are, but I put it all in millimeters just because, I don't know, if you work in inches you can convert it. I'm not gonna put both. So anyway, so I'll take a picture of this, post it at the end of the video. Hopefully it helps. I think this is a fairly common question with these guns, or similar guns to this, which I don't know if there's other ones, other models, other ones that are the same as this, but hopefully it helps. I guess if you have any questions, post them down below, I guess. Maybe I can measure something again, or clarify something, or anyway. Thanks for watching. We'll talk to you later.